Hello people, in this video we want to look at this topic squint or strabismus, both are same. So how do you define it? Look at this image here, the first one. The visual axis of two eyes are parallel to each other in the primary position of gaze, and this alignment is maintained in all positions of gaze. This is normal. Okay, visual axis of the two eyes are parallel to each other. So remember this parallel concept, okay? So whichever way you look, the eyes, the visual axis of both the eyes will be parallel to each other, okay? Now what happens in squint? The misalignment of the visual axis of the two eyes is called squint or strabismus, both same word, okay? So in squint or strabismus, there is misalignment of the visual axis of the two eyes, squint or strabismus. So squint or strabismus is which one? This one, okay? So the first one is called what? Orthophoria. This is called as what? Orthophoria, where it is parallel and perfect. Okay. Now here there is one concept in orthophoria. Understand this. That concept is called as apparent squint or pseudo strabismus. Okay. So you feel that they have a squint, but they don't. Okay. So the visual axes are in fact parallel, but the eyes seem to have a squint. And this may be because some people will have prominent epicanthal fold, which covers the visible nasal aspect of the globe and gives a false impression of esotropia. And there could be hypertelorism, a condition of wide separation of the two eyes. So if the eyes are too separated, then you feel that probably they have a squint. So that is apparent squint. Apparent squint. Or pseudo strabismus, but that is orthophoria. Their visual axis for both eyes are parallel. Okay. In this video, what do we want to focus on? In this video, we want to focus on learning about squint strabismus. We are not looking at orthophoria, right? Guys, in this, to understand squint, right, first of all, we have to understand this extraocular muscles, okay? We will not go into the details, but just understand that there are some extraocular muscles. Now, here we have shown the right eye. Okay, what muscles can you see here? This is superior rectus, this is inferior rectus, this is lateral rectus, this is medial rectus, right? Medial rectus. This is the right eye. So, the nose of the person is here. And here you have the left eye, which will again have superior rectus, inferior rectus, medial rectus and lateral rectus. Okay, so each of these muscles have a different nerve innervation. You should understand that. Okay, and when eye moves this side, it's abduction. When eye moves medially, it is adduction. Then you have elevation. Then you have intorsion. So many things. Elevation, depression. Then you have intorsion, extorsion. And these are the muscles which are helping, okay, in which direction, which muscle helps, you should know. And there is something called as bilocular movements, okay. Both the eyes together, they have something called as version. In binocular movement, you have something called as version and vergence. What is this versions? Versions means conjugate movements, some dextroversion, levoversion, supraversion, infraversion. So many types of versions are there. We're not going into the details. Then you have vergence, like convergence, divergence, vergence, versions. Okay. When will these two converge? For all you know, right? When simultaneous inward movement of both the eye, convergence. Okay. Converge. Why will they converge? There must be some, both the medial rectus are pulling. Interesting. Then you have divergence, then both the eyes look away, right? Simultaneous outward movement. This is another concept you need to know, guys. Synergists and antagonists, that will be in one eye only. Some synergists will be there, some antagonists will be there. Some, that means some muscles which work together are synergists. Some antagonists means one muscle, what it does, the opposite the other muscle will do. Like medial rectus will try to pull the muscle medially, lateral rectus will try to pull the pull the eyeball laterally. So those will be antagonists. So then you have yoke muscles. Yoke muscles is a concept that is between two eyes. Okay, that is where you will have contralateral synergies. That means if this eye has to turn this way, then this eye has to turn this way. So here who is helping? Medial rectus is helping. But here who is helping? Lateral rectus is helping, right? So medial rectus of one eye and the lateral rectus of the other eye are yoke muscles. They are contralateral synergies. So these are pair of muscles from each, one from each eye, which contract simultaneously during version movements. For example, the right lateral rectus and the left medial rectus act as yoke muscles. Okay. Similarly, you have another concept called as contralateral antagonists. Okay, contralateral antagonists means what? Pair of muscles, one from each eye, having opposite action. Okay, like right lateral rectus and left lateral rectus. Yes, so right lateral rectus is where here, right lateral rectus. And the left lateral rectus are contralateral antagonists. Okay. Mainly you focus on yoke muscles. Okay. If this right eye is turning this side, left eye also has to turn that side only. Right. Then only you'll have parallel, the parallel visual axis you'll have because of that only. Right. There is some something called as gaze, guys. You should know different positions of gaze. Okay. In this, the middle one is the primary gaze. This is the primary gaze. Okay. Secondary will be BDFH. Where is B? BDFH. Up, down, left, right. This is secondary, and remaining are tertiary. Okay. So which are tertiary, guys? This is tertiary, 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 tertiary. Okay. Then guys, there's something called as cardinal, okay, in that this and this they have taken and they're calling cardinal. Now leave that. Okay, now there are some laws which talk about how these muscles, extraocular muscles, move. Those laws are Herring's law, equal innervation, Sherrington law for reciprocal innervation, all this. Okay, if you want, you can look at all that, but here we are not here to look at all that. We are here to look at strabismus, right? But anyways, we're just looking at some idea of the how the muscles work. There is something called as binocular single vision. That means you're seeing with two eyes, right? Two eyes you're seeing, but will you see two images? No, you will see only one image, right? In the brain, nice image, you will see only one image. That is binocular single vision. Okay, now let's get into the exact topic, that is strabismus squint. Okay, so here we are. So we have looked at these terminologies, orthophoria, or and under that we have seen apparent squint or pseudo strabismus. Now we want to go to this topic, squint or strabismus. Okay, in this squint or strabismus, guys, basic some concepts are there, understand. Okay, if the eye is deviated inward, if the squint eye is deviated inward, it is called as eso. Okay, if it is outside, it is called exo. So let us say exotropia for now, esotropia, like that. If the eye is up, it will be hypertropia. If it is below, it is called hypo. Tropia, okay, tropia, phoria, etc. Those words are there, but just remember, if it is inward, it is eso. If it is outward, it is exo. If it is upward, it's hyper. If it's below, it is hypo. Okay, there's something else called a cyclo. One more complication there. Okay, so now look at this lady. What do you think she has? If she is in the primary gaze, then this one, left one, has eso. Tropia, esotropia, because left is inward, left esotropia. Very good. Now let us guess some more. Okay, here's a kid. Tell us. This one, right eye is inward, right esotropia, right hypertropia, eye is up, eye is outward, right exotropia, eye is down, right hypotropia. Okay, so everything is fine till now, right? Now let us look at other types of squint. Okay, now in a squint, now whatever you saw till now, very apparent squint, that means you can see the person having the squint, so that will be called as tropia. So under squint, now you have two types, tropia and phoria. Tropia means what you saw now, you can clearly see that in the primary gaze the eye is left or right or up or down, inward, outward, etc. So that becomes a heterotropia. So it is also called as heterotropia. And there is another condition called as heterophoria. Okay. Heterophoria means it is also called as latent strabismus. That means here you can see the person's eyes are perfect, right? Only when they become tired or there is some decompensation, the squint becomes apparent or manifest. Okay. Phoria. This is phoria. We'll look at phoria in a separate video. And then we'll look tropia also in separate video. In tropia, you have two, concomitant and Incommittent, okay, concomitant and incommittent are two types. In concomitant, basically, the person has some underlying issue like hypermetropia, okay, myopia, right? They have some issue, some disease of the eye, and the squint is a result of all that, okay? Now, coming to incommittent, incommittent means the amount of deviation varies in different directions of gaze. Okay, so that is incommittent. So these people will have a lot of issues, okay, like diplopia, vertigo, disorientation. They will have a lot of issues because the amount of deviation varies in the different directions. Okay, so as you can see, there is some A and V pattern type of heterotropia, and this can be because some problem with the paralysis of the muscle or some restrictive movement of the muscle. Okay, so that will be incommittent. There are some specific words that they use in concomitant. In concomitant, they are using specific words like convergent, divergent. Okay, so you need to know that convergent, divergent usually will come in this concomitant. In incommittent, you will have words like paralytic, restrictive, A or V pattern of high heterotropia. Okay, then here you have heterophoria. Here they will talk about some compensation, decompensation, etc. In the next video, we will look at heterophoria in detail. Okay. And remember, in each of this, they will have that eso, exo, hyper, cyclo. Everywhere they will have that word. Eso, exo, hyper, hypo, cyclo. Everywhere they will have that word. Okay. So that you have to remember will be common to everything. Then some quick things we will look at. Okay. The heterotropia to detect, you have this Hirschberg test and cover test, okay, to detect heterotropia. And to detect heterophoria, you have this cover uncover test, Maddox rod, Maddox wing, etc. To fix these causes, right, mainly they will fix the cause, okay, wherever the cause can be fixed, they will fix the cause. For convergent squint, they are talking about some accommodative, then they'll give some specs and that person will be fine, okay. And otherwise, they're talking about surgeries of the muscles, extraocular muscles. And they can give prisms also to control diplopia and all that. They will give prisms. And extraocular muscles, they will have to cut. And they'll have to fix this squint. So muscles, how they are doing? They are doing recession, resection. Okay. Muscle is moved backward is recession. Muscle part, they are removing completely. That is muscle resection. Okay, so all these things they are doing. In this video, we started off with squint strabismus. We looked at how it is different from orthophoria, where there's parallel visual axis of both eyes. And in squint strabismus, there will not be parallel visual axis of both eyes. In orthophoria itself, there's a terminology called as apparent squint or pseudo strabismus. Though the person doesn't have any squint, you feel that they have, okay, when you look at them. So that is apparent squint or pseudostrabismus, but their visual axis of both the eyes will be parallel, okay. Then what did we see? Then we saw extraocular muscles and the muscles, which way they pull, etc. movement, which muscle is responsible, all that, okay. Then we saw what synergists are, what antagonist muscles are. Then we saw what yoke muscles are. Yoke muscles are important. Okay. Then we saw gazes, different gazes. We saw primary gaze, secondary positions, tertiary positions, etc. Then we saw cardinal positions. Then we saw that there are some laws called as Herring's law of equal innervation, Sherrington laws of reciprocal innervation. This is equal innervation and this is some reciprocal innervation. Anyways, we didn't go into the details of this. Then binocular single vision, you are using two eyes, but you see only one image. Then we saw different terminologies like eso, exo, hyper, hypo, cyclo. Then we saw esotropia, hypertropia, exotropia, hypotropia. Then we have looked at the major classification of strabismus, heterotropia and heterophoria. Each of these details we will go in the subsequent videos. Okay, bye bye.